Today I have a project life process video for you. If you're new to my channel, I am doing project life in a very different form at this particular time. The majority of the time, every month, I am just doing a double spread of kind of highlighting what happened that month. But when special events happen, I like to add an additional sleeve in. So that's what I'm doing today. So I really, really do hope you enjoy this video. I'll stop rambling and I'll show you the process. For this particular spread, I ended up documenting my mum's birthday. Now you'll see on the first page, this ended up being a 12 by 12 page protector that I ended up cutting down, just so that it was able to fit in the size of photos that I had and the amount that I had printed. Now for this particular spread, I ended up having a combination of 3x4s in a portrait and a landscape version, just like this one here with the snowdrops. And I ended up having to dig deep into my page protector collection and find some others that would obviously fit the bill. Now, I don't know whether there's anyone else out there that struggles with any other design, but I really, really struggle with this particular design spread. My particular page protectors that I love and use all the time are the Becky Higgins Design A, and I very rarely deter away from that particular design, and if necessary I will take photos out so that I can obviously, you know, I can basically just use Design A. It's Design A or no design. But I don't know whether there's anyone else out there that struggles with other kind of particular page protectors and spreads, but this happens to be one of them. I ended up having two large pockets as a 6x4, and I have no idea what I was going to do. All my photos were landscape. There was no portrait photos of me and my mum. I was like, oh my god, what do I do? So I thought, well, I might as well use it as a filler card, and that's pretty much what I ended up doing. I ended up having a couple of filler cards and some journal cards, and to be fair, it worked out all for the best, so I will not be complaining anymore. Plus, I ended up having to use one of my old page protectors, which means I have less to use up in the future, which is a win-win all round. Now, all I ended up doing for that one was just adding some kind of die cuts onto a page, and then obviously adding some glitz here and there with my Winsor & Newton Gold ink. But for this one, I end up going a little bit more gold, so to speak. I love gold. It's probably one of the metallics that I use most often, and I have a range of the coppers and more of a rose gold plus the gold. But I ended up wanting to mix some of the metals for this particular spread, and I ended up adding some gold alphas to this title card, which you will see in a little while. This little tag was from one of my cut apart sheets. I can't quite remember the collection, but it's one that I've had kind of cut up for quite some time. So I thought, well, it's pink, it's pretty, we saw quite a lot of birds, it's coming up for spring-ish, even though we've had the snow. So I thought I might as well use it in one form or another. Now, like I said, I end up using two or more different kind of, I want to say they are metals. So I end up combining the gold for the mum and the 53, because that's how old she is, for using two different style of alphas and two different combinations of the metallics. And I actually really, really liked how this turned out. And I think in future I'm going to mix my metallics a little bit more, because I really, really like the design. The majority of this layout ends up being quite pink, and if you're kind of quite new to my channel, the majority of my layouts in the past have been quite blues and greens, so it was quite nice to actually adventure into the pink papers that I have in my collection, because I've got quite a lot of them. And recently I ended up being able to have the chance from one of my subscribers, basically allowed me to buy the Gather collection and the Bloom paper pad collection from Maggie Holmes from her. And again, they have lots of beautiful pink, so it was really, really nice to use that in this spread. This particular card was one from Studio Calico. I ended up just adding a tiny word sticker that says, there is beauty in this, oh my god, I'm not going to be able to say that last word. Simplicity! There we go! obviously showing you my gold hands. Does anyone else have like destroyed hands or clothes by the time they leave their craft room? Hopefully it is not just me. I thought that my gold ink was going to be absolutely fine, and then it basically exploded on me, which was not fine on any means. But just adding a few tiny puffy stickers just to speed this up, and obviously add the words Leeds Castle, and I am done. Now, this might seem like a very, very short video, mainly because the photos that I ended up having in this particular layout, I didn't necessarily embellish. I wanted the photos to stand out for themselves, so that's the majority of them. And the other thing is some of the pockets are filled up with kind of journaling, which I don't necessarily do on camera anymore, because at the end of the day, you guys don't want to end up watching me just, just write out my life story. So this is just a quick glimpse of some of the photos I took with my mum and celebrating her wonderful birthday. Well guys, what did you think? Please let me know in the comments below what your thoughts were and what your favourite part of this process was. And if you're new to my channel, hello and welcome. I'm the Tattooed Crafter here in England, and I do a whole series of creative videos every Tuesday and every Friday. So if you're new to my channel and you'd love to see more, please consider subscribing. It's that big red button over there. It's big, it's red, and it's free. And if you do subscribe, please make sure you click that little bell button. YouTube's been a bit sneaky recently, so if you click that little bell button, you will then be notified on my next upload. But without further ado guys, I really really do hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, smash the thumbs up button for me, and I'll see you guys very very soon.